Hello, here's a short story about a guy that I worked with in that little magical working group in Bonn while hanging out at the university. That guy didn't complete his studies because he became quite successful in business. And I think that might be another story that I might tell another time. That dude, let's call him Frater Shin, because that was the name we used for him in that little working group. Shin, the letter of fire. Well, as a matter of fact, he was a fire worshipper, to an extent that he was a kleptomaniac about lighters. So whenever he paid a visit to me afterwards, all my lighters were gone, if I didn't watch out. And at some point I really started to watch out, and I almost patted him down to find all my lighters before he went. Well, when that dude was successful in business after he left Bonn, his leaving Bonn would be another story, but not for this series, because it was nothing about magic. It was about drug abuse and what that does to your reputation. Well, before that guy, after that guy left Bonn, sorry. After that guy left Bonn and became successful in the world of business, he worked in London for some time, and the other day he called me from London. And he was in some bookstore, in some occult bookstore, and I asked him to describe that bookstore to me, because I was in London some years before that, and of course I visited a lot of occult bookstores, and as a matter of fact his description made me come up with a name. He asked the guy behind the counter, is this that bookstore? I'm not sure if it was Atlantis bookstore or Watkins. I think it was Watkins Limited, and it was the bookstore that I identified by his description. Very nice bookstore. I hope it still exists. The reason why he called me from that bookstore was they offered him a picture, an original from Austin Osman Spare, with a little certificate of authenticity. Authenticity sounds strange, but yes, I think that's the word. For £300, about 500 D-mark. I'm not sure about how much that would be in euros, and I don't care. Now the problem was, that dude, Frater Shin, he never understood Austin Spare. He never understood sigil magic. He made some almost intellectualized playing with symbols out of sigil magic. And I'm not sure, I think he never really read Spare. He only read books about sigil magic and about Austin Spare, but never ever something like The Book of Pleasure or The Focus of Life. And when you read these books, you might come to the conclusion that Austin Spare didn't really want to tell anyone what he was really doing. He just wrote those books, and especially in The Book of Pleasure, you always find these footnotes about chapters that he omitted. So he didn't want to teach. And he didn't want others to copy him. When you read the Anathema of Zos, you're forced to come to that conclusion. I love that book. Knowing Frater Shin, I knew that he called me to brag. Look, I'm here in London, I'm offered this picture and I got the money to pay for it and I can buy it now. Aren't you jealous? No, I wasn't. I knew that he would just put this picture in his apartment and brag with it to people that wouldn't understand what the guy was talking about. So I told Frater Shin, well, do what thou wilt. And of course, he bought that picture. At least some days later he called me and told me that he bought that picture. And that wasn't all that he told me. He told me a bit more, because after he bought that picture, he and a friend went to some bar or cafe and they had a coffee, and later that evening Frater Shin realized that he forgot that picture and the certificate of authenticity in that cafe. And I swear, somewhere in the astral plane, I heard Austin Spare laughing out loud. What would that dude, Frater Shin, do with that picture? Well, as Aleister Crowley wrote, some pieces of art are still protected by those that created those pieces. Yeah, that's what I make of that story. Except for making it a good joke. I think it's one of the best jokes when it comes to occultism, because it's true. See ya.